Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin, Rhett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Welcome Back Kotter, Helene Lambeck, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rammer.
Johnny Olson and friends, thank you for joining us here. What, are you passing notes already?
No.
Laughing at
everything.
You laughed at something. What was it?
You rascal.
What?
He's hiding back there.
Who?
Jack.
Ah.
The Ripper.
No.
Jack, it's everything is okay. In case the microphone goes bad, he was going to bring out another microphone. That's his job.
That's very
okay.
Nice.
Hey, hey, Jack.
Those are before my time. Definitely.
No.
The other one was working.
That one. Is he on camera? Oh, now it's working. Oh, all right. We'll use it for a little while, Jack. Did Jack get on camera? He might as well get his $52. What the heck? Okay.
We don't have a finish for this, do we?
You could always say, let's meet our
players. Oh, what do you say we say hello to Laurie Smith and Debbie Finnerman over here? Tell you, it hurts right here. All right. Now listen, Laurie's a current champ. She has $10,250. Congratulations to her. And Debbie has had her first round question match one of our celebrities. You know what this is named? This is a 44D, isn't it? B.
Oh, what? That's Fanny Flagg's bra size.
Yeah. Well, that's a designation for this microphone. Are you ready to carry on, ladies? All right, would one of you hold my microphone, please? Well, we'll start here in the middle of round one, right after we do a little business with you out there. Okay, here we go. Middle of round one. Laurie, this is your first round question. Some people take milk baths, but not Weird Wanda. She goes one step further. She takes blank baths. Weird Wanda.
People take milk baths.
But not Weird Wanda. She goes one step further. She takes blank baths.
I haven't been crazy about the last several questions. I didn't like that one we had before.
Brett is complaining about the quality of the writing. Would you take that in mind, please?
Yes.
There's one of the writers there who's cutting his wrist at this very moment.
I'll see you in Jean's dressing room.
Cute. She takes blank baths. All right.
Weird Wanda.
We're not going to wait for you, Brett.
Okay, hon.
Laurie, some people take milk baths, but not Weird Wanda. She goes one step further. She takes blank baths. What? What are you laughing at?
Nothing.
Tell us what you're laughing at, my dear.
Why
we want to enjoy the humor with you. Are you feeling hysterical?
Sorry.
Now, hold on now. Just a second now. Have you got a problem? No.
Sounds like.
Have you got an answer?
Yes.
What? You don't want to say it. Would you write it down?
No.
Throw me a pencil and I'll let her write it down. If she can't say it, why? I guess I'll just have to have her write it.
Has she got a case of the giggles?
No. Just write the answer right down here, right there, and then you can keep on giggling as you write. What the hell's so funny about that?
Nothing. It's the audience.
Well, the audience has got you hysterical. Well, her answer is a whiskey bath. Thank you. That would sting, wouldn't it?
It would sting.
Why would that sting?
Oh, bad enough with Aquavalva. No, I say Ready Whip.
Ready Whip. Ready Whip. What'd you say, Brett?
I said have a can of Coors. Beer.
Beer.
Thank you, darling.
I said cream, keeping in with the...
Well, from milk to cream. Some people take milk baths. Weird Wanda goes one step further. She takes whiskey baths.
Being the clean-cut young American that I am, I said gin.
Gin.
I said liquor.
Gin, liquor. Now, hold on just a second. Would you like to...
Oh, wait, under... I said liquor.
I am not speaking to you. I am addressing our judge. It says liquor. Gin here, and underneath says liquor. Okay, all right, just wanted to check with you.
Oh, we're getting particular.
Wanted to make sure you understood. Yes, Richard. Weird Wanda goes one step further than the milk bath. She takes...
A bird bath.
Bird bath. Good.
Put five pigeons in the cup. Call me.
Ruffles or feathers. Ruffles or feathers and everything.
You should wash all over or not at all. Yogurt.
Yogurt. Okay. I go to round two here and ask Debbie to make a selection.
I'll try B this time.
You want B? All right, one person does not play, and that is Richard.
I'll take a bird bath. Buddy.
You take a bird bath while we're waiting. Nerdocrumbesia, such a stupid country, the Secretary of the Treasury is blank. It's a stupid country, Nerdocrumbesia.
Stupid country.
The Secretary of the Treasury is blank. That's a good one.
That is?
Oh, yes.
Thank you for telling me.
I love your actor's energy level. You just pull a whole show right up.
Okay. All right, now let's all perk up. I don't care for that one either. I guess it must be me.
It is you.
Now, don't copy.
Let her copy if she wants to.
Better let me copy or I'm not going to have anything. Okay. Stupid country.
The Secretary of the Treasury is... All right.
Okay.
Well, we're going to start
without
you.
I can't think of anything, so I'll just have to put...
This isn't a hard one, is it, Debbie?
We'll
very
see.
Easy one. Here we go.
He's having a hard time, too.
Well, he always does. Nerdocrumbesia is such a stupid country. The Secretary of the Treasury is...
Bert Lance.
Well, certainly. What is so hard about
that's
that?
Right. I did not... You know, I was not playing. What's my answer?
Bert Lance, it says right there. Yes. And then not only did they not get the right answer, they're too dumb.
How do you know that we didn't get the right answer? How do you know we didn't get the right answer?
Well, he said he's broke.
Well, he has won
pretty close.
The Secretary of the Treasury is broke. Now, that's a good answer, but it's not what she's looking for.
I want you to know something, Mr. Smart Blank.
Tell him, baby.
Yes?
I'm too smart for the room. I threw out Bert Lance and in desperation brought it back.
Oh! Why did you throw it out?
Because he is not a citizen of the country and I thought you had to be a citizen of
Nerdo. Of Nerdocrumbesia, I see. Okay. Charles?
A thief.
A thief.
Stinks.
No, it's not bad. Secretary of the Treasury is a thief. But what's so new about that? Hello there.
Oh, you just want it straight out, huh?
Yep.
Straight out. You get right to the point.
Flat, right up. Secretary of the Treasury is Bert Lance.
Okay.
Now, Miss Betty, honey, what do you say about the Secretary of the Treasury?
Richard tried to help. He wrote wasted three different cards writing it,
yep.
And I figured that was copying, so I said a convicted bank robber.
A convicted bank robber.
I can't help that.
Listen.
What a sweet person.
You can copy from him. I don't care. Hello there. Now, here it is. 3-0. You're going to have one shot at it after we do a little business with America. Pay attention. Now, Laurie, here's the way it is. You need 3 to tie and 4 to win. Are you ready?
Ready.
Nancy said, my husband, the meat inspector, is always thinking about his work. Last night, he stamped USDA choice on my blank. Okay, Laurie. Nancy said, my husband, the meat inspector, is always thinking about his work. Last night, he stamped USDA choice on my blank.
Fanny.
Okay. 3 Fannies to tie, 4 to win.
First tush.
There it is. There's one for her. 3-1 is the score. Rat?
Is it Easter?
No, it's January.
I have some hot cross buns.
Score is now 3-2. One more will tie the score.
Of course it's Easter, my dear. Rump.
All right. 3-3 to score. Another pair of buns will win the game. What do you say?
Well, I put rear end... That's it. And it's cute.
And it's cute, and that means Laurie wins the game. There we go, Danny. There we go, Danny. Debbie, you came that close. Good luck to you, my dear.
Thank
We're going to have some gifts for you. A 12-year supply of all kinds of lovely things that you're really going to love. Debbie Finnerman. Now, Laurie... You have $10,350. You're up here for the 6th time, and here we go again. We polled the studio audience, and we said write down your best response to this. Bionic blank. Remember, $500 for matching the most popular answer, $250 for the second, and $100 for the third. And you are allowed to call on 3 of our 6 for help.
Dick.
Bionic woman.
All right. He says bionic
I'll
woman.
Richard.
Bionic man.
All right. Bionic man.
Brett.
Bionic buns. No.
Other two
bionic
good...
boy. But there's a bionic boy. Isn't there one?
Yes, there was.
That one's coming in.
All right. The two good ones are gone, Brett, so it's really tough. Almost anything you say here will be acceptable.
Bionic dog.
Okay, bionic dog, bionic man, bionic woman. What do you want to do?
Bionic man.
You want to say bionic man? She said bionic man. All right, let's find out. If bionic man is up there, we'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Bionic dog. Very good.
So glad I changed my mind.
He's a $6 million man, but it's all right.
You made a mistake?
I admit it.
You didn't mean to say bionic man?
Well, no. I forgot that he's a $6 million man.
Yeah.
Well, he's bionic.
I didn't even realize the bionic woman was easy.
May we see the $250 response? Bionic man. Congratulations. You got that.
All right.
No doubt. The big one's on top there. The woman. May we see her? There it is. Okay, now, you're going to play for $2,500. And to win, going to try again?
Richard.
All right. Good luck to you, Laurie. Here it is, worth $2,500, and it reads as follows. Foam blank. That's F-O-A-M blank. Foam blank. All right, Laurie, what answer would you like to give us which you think will match his? If you do match it, You get $2,500.
Rubber?
Foam rubber. Okay. Foam rubber will match it. Cut.
Pardon?
Nothing. I was just talking to Benny. Rubber. There it is. Now you got $13,100. Congratulations to you. And for America, we've got a message or two.
Today's consolation prizes are first, Allen and Country tableware by Washington Ford. Beautiful Friedman handles and mirror bright stainless steel dishwasher safe from Washington Ford. And a radio and a supply of blue ribbon colossal pistachios grown in California sweeter and larger. It's the love nut. Colossal pistachios, blue ribbon is nuts. And a wall clock and a supply of Welch's sparkling grape soda, refreshing and lively, bubbly and bouncy, because you've never really tasted grape soda before until you've tried Welch's. And a warming tray and a supply of Swanson's beef enchiladas and chili sauce for meat, Mexican lasagna, German and Polynesian style dinners, and you buy Swanson dinners, you really get your money's worth. Show goes on with Gene Raver.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. And now let's all welcome Francis Patrick. Hello, Francis. What would you like to say that will acquaint us with you?
That I have a son, 5 years old. His name is Stephen.
Yeah.
That I like to dance, play tennis, and study astrology.
Really?
Astrology?
Astrology.
Uh-huh.
What, may I ask what that is there?
That's a symbol for a Capricorn.
You are a Capricorn. Yeah. So your birthday is in December or January, is it?
January.
Yes. What is that, actually?
It really is a symbol for Capricorn.
Oh, it is.
A lot of people think it says 76, but it isn't.
Mm-hmm. Does that bother you? I mean, can you see through that?
No, it doesn't bother me.
May I? Would you take it off and may I just see what it looks like there? I, too, am a Capricorn.
Very good.
You're right. It doesn't bother your vision at all. That's very good. Now, what does your sign tell you about what's going to happen in the next 10 minutes?
My sign doesn't tell me anything about that.
Oh. What does it say, take A or B?
My son said to take B.
Your sign says take B?
Son.
Oh, your son. Oh. All right. Horrible Hannah is really horrible. Instead of baby's shoes hanging from her car's rear view mirror, she has baby's blanks hanging from her mirror. Horrible Hannah. Very good. Okay. I'll help you with the smelling of that. Nothing wrong with that. Okay. Come on, Charles.
Oh, he's doing artwork. When he thinks of
well,
the
well, while Charles is doing his artwork, I'll read it to you one more time, Francis. Horrible Hannah is really horrible. Instead of baby shoes hanging from her car's rear view mirror, she has baby's blanks hanging from her mirror.
Feet.
Feet. Feet. She said feet.
Feet.
Dear me.
Interesting.
Yes.
Grotesque, but interesting.
Right.
I said diapers.
Diapers. All right.
Now, I want to preface my answer with the fact that I'm a mother, and sometimes we all us mothers, have to go a little crazy once
Betty,
in a while.
Ready.
Yes.
I'm not ready for this. Okay.
Baby's heads. Woo! All the mothers out there know what I mean.
Feet and heads. Dear me.
Diapers.
Diapers.
Okay, Helene, instead of baby's shoes hanging from her car's rearview mirror, she has baby's feet.
Well,
no.
Since I just got babysitting for my godchild last night and changed a lot of diapers, I said diapers.
Diapers seems to be the definitive answer, Francis. What do you say, Richard?
What a lovely story. Diapers.
Diapers. Yes, my dear.
All right. Why not?
There it is. Diapers. Got them all. Now let's see what Laurie does with her first round question. Tom said, I went fishing with Ugly Edna. She is so ugly. Shut up. She's so ugly, not only did she scare away the fish, she scared away the blank. went fishing with Ugly Edna. She's so ugly, not only did she scare away the fish, she scared away the blank. Right.
Did you see the sign that said speed up?
Okay. Laurie, Tom said, I went fishing with Ugly Edna. She's so ugly, not only did she scare away the fish, she scared away the blank.
The bait?
The bait is a good answer. Okay, Dick.
She's gonna match.
There's one for her. What do you say?
Them little worms just took off.
Bait. Charles?
The water.
Scared away the water. What do you say?
I said the worms and bait.
Worms and bait. That's three for her. Richard?
Bait and worms.
Bait and worms.
Mosquitoes.
Very good. Yeah, so there you got four, and now we've got this just for you. Listen, you were all just grand.
Thank you.
Grand,
we were
grand,
just
grand.
Talking among ourselves.
Who was
we
the
will
best?
Look forward. Well, let's see. Who was the best? Eeny, meeny. No, I can't do that. You were all lovely. And I hope you'll join us next time for Match Game 78. Gene Avery here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.